There is no one like you that do.
Jesus,
there is no one like you. Open up, keeping God. There is no one like you, Lord. Alpha Omega. There is no one like you. Oh, the God.
The Son of Man.
You are the only
God.
There is none
like you.
Oh,
the God.
You are the Son of Man. You are the
only Lord.
There is none
like you.
Oh, that
goes.
We are the works of man. You are the
holy Lord.
There is no
like you.
You are the Lord. You are the Lord. You are the eyes that used to see. You are the key that opens the door. You are the owner of my soul. The bull that bonded me down. What shall I render to you, O Lord? I will bow down and worship you. You are the Lord. You are the Lord. You are the Lord. You are the Lord. You are the eyes that used to see. You are the key that opens the door. You are the owner of my soul. The Buddha opened the never consumed. What shall I render to you, O Lord? I will bow down and worship you. You are the Lord. I will bow down. I will bow down and worship your name. You are the Lord. You are the Lord. I will bow down and worship your name. You are the Lord. Let's open our mouth and worship him. Open your mouth and give him praise. Give him honor. Give him adoration. Let's worship him. Let's adore him. Let's magnify his name. Let's glorify his name. Let's thank him. Let's thank him. Let's thank him. Let's thank him. There's none like unto him. Give him thanks. Give him praise. Give him honor. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Father, you are worthy. That day you are worthy. That day you are worthy. Mercy and do it forever. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give adoration. Blessed be your name. Honor be your name. Adoration be unto your name, Lord. We give you praise, Lord. Thank you. Now come in today. The ninth day into the hands of God. Ask God that God should answer you by fire today. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Come in today. Today is the ninth day of the fasting and prayer. Cover your prayer today by the blood of Jesus. Thank you. Cover by the blood. In the name of Jesus. Father, we cover today by the blood of Jesus, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father.
In
Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we want to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, this is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Today is the ninth day of the 30 days fasting and prayer.
Amen.
Father, answer us speedily in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, answer us speedily in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let power shine down in our life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let power shine down in our life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let every power troubling us in Europe, let that power die by thunder in Jesus' name.
Yes.
That power that say we will not carry goods home, that say we will not achieve before we go home, that power must die in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You are welcome to the ninth day of the fasting and prayer. And straight, we want to go straight to the business. You know, it's just prayer. We only have 30 minutes. And I told you that we'll be having a guest, a man that God is using mightily in Edo State, Benin City. He's very popular in Benin City, even when for the 8 years of Governor Oshomole, you cannot remove his name in the Benin or Edo State. So popular, you can ask any of our family. He's very popular. I always call him Oshomole Police. He's the right man of Governor Oshomole, and he's a pastor. I always call him Oshomole Police. So if you have your family in Nigeria, you ask him Oshomole Police, they will tell you that man is very good, but his boys are very bad. The man is good, but his boys are very bad. They can tow your car, they can carry your car anywhere. They carry it away. Even the governor car, they feel carry them. The even governor car, they carry them. Whether you be governor, whatever it is, they will carry the car. Very popular. He's here with us. He's a pastor in Benin, well recognized. Please permit me as to put you together as I welcome my Boston friend, Pastor Amadi Owas. Please put your hands together for him.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I am glad to be with us this day. Today is a significant day to everyone. To start by thanking the wife and every one of us that are present today.
Amen.
All that we do, we are doing it again and again for God today.
Amen.
All that you hear him saying was for the people of the world. But today we are reversing it to begin to do it for God, using our own time, our energy, and all that we have to do the work of God.
Yes, sir.
But I want to say thank you, everyone. Thank you, my bishop, for the opportunity. Thank you for my man in Milan. May God continue to bless every one of you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We want to go into prayers, but let me quickly say these two things, or rather this statement, why we are praying. Why today is a significant day to every one of us present here today. By 30 days in our calculation, we are having 21 days left. And I want you to know that 3 is a very significant number in our spiritual race. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Now, if you are going to divide the 21 days left by 3, you have 7 days. And we all know what happened on the 7 days that the Bible says God labored on the 7 days he rested. And on the last day of this program, the Lord will grant us rest in every area of our sight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say the Lord will grant us rest. Rest run about in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want us to look at the word of God this morning. I hope we are ready to pray. It is by the closeness that he tried to he break my protocol today. Today is always my prayer day. And my phone is on every Monday from 5 in Nigeria time. But he said, I must be with us as a family today.
Jesus.
I want us to look at the book of Second Samuel chapter 4. I want you to mark today. Second Samuel chapter 4. Verse 4. I don't know who have carried you, and I don't know who have followed you. Somebody have tempered with our destiny. Somebody have carried us. Somebody have followed us. I don't know who that person is this evening or this afternoon. But I have good news for every one of us for this program. For the program have been put together for our church, for those who have tempered with our life, have tempered with our destiny, for God to change our life. In 2 Samuel chapter 4, verse 4, he said, and Jonathan saw Saul have a son that was lame of his feet. He was 5 years adult of Israel, and his nurse, I want you to take care of that, his nurse took him up and fled, and it came to pass, as she made haste to flee, he fell and became lame. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And his name was Mephibosheth. There is this man called Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the grandson of Saul. We all know what happened by right. Jonathan was supposed to inherit a throne. But it happened that both of them died together, and the son and the grandson, who is the son of Jonathan, supposed to have taken over. But the enemy said no. I don't know who among us today that the enemy is saying no unto. That for us to be God wants us to become, God wants us to bring in. I say no, we are not going to let them to become salty until we bring them down. Mm-hmm. But I have good news for you.
Amen.
Look at the man called Mephibosheth. He was not laid from the womb. He was not laid at the age of 1 year. He was not laid at the age of 2 years. Myself and you, we know that if a child of 5 years, no matter how they fall, that a child of 5 years will fall, that will cause that child to be paralyzed for all the days of his life. But the enemy have done this. The enemy have done this. And the Bible says, when they heard the news of what have happened, how Jonathan and Esau, I mean a son, what happened, their captain, the nurse carried him, who was watching over. He said, let me carry the child and let me fled. Let me move that to another country. The process of running, both of them fell down. The question is, why was the nurse not paralyzed? How come Mephibosheth, who have destiny, who have whatever he want to become in life, I will show you I don't know who are carrying you think this is organized, but this did. Whoever that have tampered with my destiny, whoever that have tampered with my future, whatever who have carried me in my father's house, whoever that have carried me in my husband's house, who have said no, I will not become. That most of all keep struggling, nothing seems to be working out. We are just struggling, we are circling from one place to the other. But look at this young man. Somebody carried him. Somebody has fallen. We are going to say God tonight. That is why I ask, are we ready to pray? We are going to pray. Mephibosheth was destined to become a king. Mephibosheth was destined to become a ruler. But the enemy said no. We are going to pray tonight. Whoever that have carried me, that have formed, people who pretend to love evil personality, they pretend to love us, they are the one that is doing us, and they are the one that is tearing us apart. We are going to pray tonight. Whoever that have carried me to fall, whoever that have carried me, you know, falling me or will fall me down, that I will not become what I want to become in life. Tonight, we are going to raise up our voice. We are going to say, God, whatever altar that I be raised against me in my father's house, whatever altar that be raised against me for people that have raised friends, taking my name from one place to another, whoever that is carrying my name from one place to another, tonight I say, God, arise and set confusion into their midst. Open your mouth and say, God, set confusion into their midst. God, set confusion into their midst. Whoever that have carried me, who have for me, a cup of tolo, go tole, baba, make it tole, no, mercy. Mephibosheth is supposed to be a king. Supposed to be a king. You are supposed to be a ruler. But somebody have carried you. Somebody have found you. Begin to destroy that altar. Some of us started that heavy problem the very moment we start sending money home. Some of us started having problem the moment we start building home. Some of us started having problem that yet things will not work out. Some of us started having problem of not getting married. Some of us started having problem when we start saying we want to help one another. Somebody have carried you. Somebody have followed you. Whoever that is following who pretend to be your own. That are following you, that is following you, that are taking your name to one place or the other. Let us open our mouth to begin to pray tonight. Let us open our mouth to begin to pray tonight. I have taken my name to this matter, to defend this matter, to defend this matter, to defend this matter. Bring back the yada. The Somebody have someone. I don't know who I'm carrying you. I don't know who I'm carrying you. People of God, whether Satan like it or not, in this many 21 days, somebody say 21 days.
21 days.
In 21 days, somebody must be liberated.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody must be set free.
Amen.
I don't care to know who have carried you. That one thing is sure. Your destiny must come back to life.
Amen.
I don't care to know who have carried you. I don't care to.
Nigeria network.
No, I follow you. Amen. To say, God, every foundation, every altar, wherever my name has been, whoever that has set altar up to put my name, tonight I am praying. Every altar, every wrong altar that yes, somebody has taken my name to. I set that altar. I set that altar on fire. I set that altar on fire. I set that altar on fire. Set that altar on fire. I set that altar on fire. I get to set this altar on fire.
We are not hearing. Can you change your position? The line is seizing. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Quickly tell you this. I learned that to you again. Quickly tell you this testimony.
The line is speaking.
I'm hearing you.
Are you
hearing me?
Can you put your other network? Can you change your position?
Can you hear me now?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, we are hearing you.
I hear you, sir.
Can you hear me now? We are not hearing again.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Satan is a liar.
Satan is a liar.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, you can hear now.
Yes, sir, we are hearing.
Oh, Nigeria, God help Africa.
Amen.
The name of Jesus.
Nigeria.
Okay. So that while we are praying, we know what. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh, my God. Some years ago, I was sleeping as a pastor. Suddenly, in the midnight, I shouted, I said, my wife, something had bite my hand.
Oh.
Something had bite my hand. I wake up. We are looking for something. We couldn't find anything, but there was no mark. But I was feeling the pains. I was feeling the pains. I never knew that somebody had carried me, somebody had for me. I wake up right from that moment, people of God, everything about me ceased. Nothing was working out. And I asked my wife, I keep asking, what is happening? And this thing lingered on for so many, many years. I didn't know what to do. And I started using. I was not having car any longer. Myself, who have worked and have spent so many years in the government, these were not working well any longer. People of God, Satan is a bastard.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. It's a wicked thing, and we must disgrace him.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So while we are praying, when your bishop organized a prayer we normally do in the night, one day, I became so sad. Until you are angry for some certain thing, you will not have a breakthrough.
And so,
yes, sir.
Until you become uncomfortable in that your situation, you will not have a breakthrough. I became so angry. I became so worried. I said, God, this cannot be. One day, just like today, I was doing my prayer. The Lord appeared unto me and said, where is that hand that something bite you? I said, hand. Instantly, something reminded me that this thing that happened, people of God, happened about close to about 5 years ago. As soon as I was leaving the government, happened as at that time. I swung all over the whole places. to eat and to get finance my home, my children became a problem. The only thing that saved me, I was no longer paying house rent. Mm. And people were saying, there is power, but it is God who is keeping every one of us.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And suddenly, I said, God, and I said, this is the hand, my right hand. I said, yes, that is it. And he took my hand. How did it happen? In that revelation when God appeared to me, it was like a program like this. And somebody was asking me in that dream, will Adeboye come? I said, but I've organized a program. I'm not a member of Redeem. I don't know if he will come. Suddenly, as I was coming, Adeboye appeared. People of God, there are times when you are going through things, you are going through time in life, your pastor will appear before you.
Mm-hmm.
It might not be your pastor, it could be the angel of God that is using your pastor to appear to resolve that problem at a time.
Amen.
That is the purpose of this prayer. Now, suddenly, the man, as he was running up, I was putting things together. Then somebody said, a woman said to him, so the man said, every program you see that have happened here today, this is the man who have put it together, who have organized this program, who have something. He said, Nida. It was when I Nida, he asked me that question, where is that hand that somebody, something bite you? I remember instantly that this happened some years ago. People of God, a young man was carried, he tried to, you know, run away, he fell down. Arrived from that moment, he became lame. But I have said to you tonight by the mandate God has given to Ross. Your pastor. Everyone that has been fall down by the wicked one, to do you are getting. Not in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I say today you are coming alive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are coming alive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I go back to as a pastor. Something that happened years ago, it was this about 2 months ago, God gave me deliverance. If it can happen to me as a pastor, think about you who is just a member, and it can happen to any other person. Tonight, I agree with your pastor that every power working against you, working against your family, working against your life, working against your children, working against your marriage, today I put that down in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I put that down in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I put that down in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The question is, the Mephibosheth, did he remain where he is? But he was became a lay person. But something happened below the God. I'm going to be taking, starting from there, by the special grace of God. But one thing was that he found favor, but he could not become a king any longer because he was already paralyzed. He was already a lay person. In Israel, you don't use somebody that is being paralyzed to make him a king.
Oh God.
But a time came, David, after so many years, David returned and found favor in the sight of David. And he came alive again, but he could not be a king. But your own case will never be like that in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say your case will never become like that in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not only see the manifestation of God in your life, but you will stay to reap the fruit of your labor. What God has given you to become, you will become in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And those people that have carried you, who have followed you, some of them will become your messenger. Some of them will become your cleaner. Some of them will become your watchman, your Jonathan will become your messenger in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let me tell you, and I will drop my microphone, I will drop my phone now. People of God, this could not have happened. I could not have got the deliverance if there was not a sacrifice. I was calling upon the name of God every day and night, bringing a sacrifice day and night. Your pastor can tell you that by December, the only car I was having, I sold it and I gave it to the house of God. I said, use it to buy equipment and everything. God, as I'm a God, that sacrifice, it was there the Lord appeared the hand that was. We have 21 days left. If you tithe 3 by 7, you have 21 days. Mm-hmm. And if you again divide, I mean, tithe 3 by 21, you have 63 days. You divide it, it bring you back to 7. And I said, on the last day, which is going to be in the 21 days, take it from today, the Lord will visit every home.
Amen.
I said, the Lord will visit every home.
Amen.
Every prayer point you are praying now, go and mark me. You will not repeat it again.
Amen.
You know why? You are paid dearly for, you are paid the due, and you are paid things for it. The
Amen.
Name of God will be glorified.
Amen.
I have hundreds of testimonies I will share. And I'm going to be with you through until the last day, and the name of God will be glorified.
Amen.
But one thing I want to let you know, Amen. There was no way I would be able to get that thing, that freedom, that breakthrough.
Jesus. Amen.
Nigeria.
Take control, oh Lord.
Holy Ghost.
Take control, God.
Holy Ghost.
No good.
Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. Okay, praise the Lord.
The time, even your person, went this, it couldn't walk.
Praise the Lord. Okay, let's begin to take the Holy Communion so that we'll not waste time before I come and do the final prayer for us. Our time is fast spent. Let's take the Holy Communion, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, before I do the final prayer for us. Okay, are you with us now, Pastor Watts? Are you with us now? Hello? Okay, let's take the Holy Communion.
Hello.
They are not hearing you. Let's take the Holy Communion, please. Prepare the Holy Communion.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, we are hearing now. You are not hearing before.
I can hear you so well.
Yeah, but we are not hearing you.
Hello, sir. You can hear me now.
Yeah, we can hear you now. Now we can hear you.
You know, Nigeria, you people keep praying for us. We are praying that Nigeria will be liberated one day.
Amen. Amen.
Please, I want you to take this word by all seriousness. Like you have said, let my name also be registered in your heart. And if nothing worked out, next time your pastor mentioned my name, you want to invite me, just tell them that pastor, I don't want you to be invited. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So these 21 days left, people of God, we are going to do something. And in these 21 days, every day, like I've said, 3 days is a significant number. and 7 days is a significant number, and 21 days is a significant number. And Jesus, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, the three in one. And also, Jesus died on the third day, the Bible says he rose up. Hallelujah. And the Bible says God walked on the 7 days. What happened? He rested. And at the end of this program, God will give you rest round about in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Man, sir, including the pastor, everybody in the house. Please, I want you to do this. The sacrifice I pay. Every altar have a sacrifice. And every altar is being answered by sacrifice. This is what you are going to do for me. I don't know how much you call it over there and how much I will call it over there. I will call it, is it 500 naira now or one arrow? Okay.
You're not hearing again, though. You're not hearing again. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
One arrow, you call it, or it, we call it 500 naira there. And it.
We can't hear you again. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Okay, let's take the Holy Communion, please.
We can't hear you. Don't come back.
I'm here, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, please, I want you to take it. And that scripture, I'm going to tell you how the man eventually had freedom. But he was laid, but your old case will not be like that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So I'm going to give 5 arrows representing God the Father, 5 arrows represent God the Son, 5 arrows represent God the Holy Spirit. That one will not be 15. Is it 15 arrows you will call it now? You are going to every day, you are, as we are coming to this program, you are going to bring whole. That 15 arrow every day, 15 arrow, 15 arrow, I didn't say 20, 15 arrow, you are going to hold it every day. As soon as you finish prayer, whether I'm there or not, you will drop it. You will drop it wherever you want to keep it, how you want to do it, you are going to, every day, 15 arrow, you will drop it. Then the second day, you also come with another 15 arrow, we are going to pay a sacrifice throughout every day, Where sometimes we continue to pray one prayer, but God who have liberated me, God who have set me free, that same God will set you free in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That same God who have liberated me, that from a bite in the night, I thought it was ordinarily, but I never knew that somebody had fought me. But God, thank God for God have brought me back to life. He have raised me as a pastor, and the name of God will be glorified. You have seen some pastor, we continue to struggle and struggle and struggle, and without knowing, not that they are not anointed, but God deliver me. So this at one, if you tithe that 15 arrow, if you choose to, you are not going to give it once. If you tithe 15 arrow by 21, I don't know how much that one will amount to, but I am not saying you should give it all once, but you are going to be giving 15 arrow every day. Every day until we get to the 21 day, and the God of heaven, the God that said God who sent Adeboye unto me in the night to tell me, to liberate me, to heal me of my hand that was injured, that was bite sometime about 7 years ago. That said God will appear unto you. That said God will deliver you. That said God will liberate you. That said God will set you free.
Amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
God will take you from Amen. To that the Lord wants you to be in Jesus. Amen. Thank you so much. God bless you, son.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you,
sir. The Lord will bless you, sir.
See you on Wednesday. Thank you, sir.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you. Let's take the Holy Communion before we round up. Before we share the grace quickly. The out of time. Our time, the line is so messing up, so we are out of our time. The Holy Communion, please. Let's take the Holy Communion quickly. Father, in the name of Jesus,
amen.
Let the power will not take the world. Let's take the world, then we pray. We'll not do any ceremony. First Corinthians chapter 11, verse 20. I lie within the world, please. Please pardon me. I lie within the word of God.
I read in
Jesus.
The Lord, that which also I deliver unto you.
Yes.
For the Lord was the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And yes. When he had returned to break bread, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. These 2 years, as often as ye drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Therefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and of the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup.
Okay, let's bow our head and examine yourself, please. That's why I like to read the word of God. Bow your head, examine yourself.
Jesus.
Ask God to forgive you. I don't want us to just take the Holy Communion anyhow. That's why I like reading the word. Bow your head, examine yourself. Ask God to forgive you. Ask God to have mercy upon you.
Let
God to cleanse you.
I will end my prayer this morning.
Father, cleanse me, Lord.
Father,
cleanse me by the blood, Lord. In the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Forgive me,
in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, all the both the bread and the cup, I want to pray on the two because of our time. Father, in the name of Jesus,
amen.
Let the power of God enter into this bread.
Amen.
Let the Spirit of God enter into this bread.
Amen.
Let the power of God enter into the cup.
Amen.
Let the Spirit of God enter it, Lord.
Amen.
Lord, let him receive the touch of power.
Amen.
Let him receive the touch of the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Let him receive the touch of the anointing of God. Let
Amen.
Him receive the touch of the power of God.
Amen.
Lord, let the bread be turned to the body of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let the food of the vine be turned to the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let him receive the touch of power in
Amen.
The name of Jesus Christ. Lord,
Amen.
As we give this body and take this blood, let
Amen.
The tabernacle and the temple of God come and dwell in us in the name of Jesus.
In the name of
let
Jesus.
The coronavirus see this
Amen.
Blood and run away.
Amen.
Let sickness and disease see this blood and run away.
Amen.
Lord, let this blood and this bread eat cancer.
Amen.
High blood pressure.
Amen.
Diabetes.
Amen.
In the name of heart disease.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord, that the power of darkness, when they see this blood and this body, that will pass
Amen.
Over us, Lord.
Amen.
Of the Father
Amen.
And of the Son
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Hey.
Amen.
And take the blood, take the bread, and take the blood. Let's bow our heads as we give God thanks. Father, thank you. Thank you as you partake in this Holy Communion. Father, we say thank you. Father, we give you praise. That we give you honor, that we give you adoration.
Amen.
You are worthy, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Be thou exalted. Be thou magnified. Be thou glorified. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take all the glory, Lord. Lord, let today's prayer be saved by the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Let's share the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
The love of God
and the sweet
fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and about us now and forevermore. Amen.
Surely,
Lord, goodness are following us
all the days,
all the
of,
days
our
of our life,
and
we shall
dwell
in the house of the Lord
forever
and ever. Amen.
Please, we will not keep long tomorrow. Please, thank you for joining us. Know that every power that caused you to be lame, that power shall die in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Go back to your king. You are a king. You must become a king in Jesus' name. Every power
yes.
that wants to stop you from becoming a king, that power will die in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every power that don't want you to achieve your destiny,
in
that
the
power will die
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
We'll see tomorrow by 5:30.
Okay.
God bless you.
God bless you.